Hello everyone, this is CoolPro195 streaming live, and this is my fifth live stream for the live stream series of Skylanders Imaginators Crash Edition for the PlayStation 4. And with me I have a bunch of guest commentators, some from the last live stream and a few new ones that have been added to the party.
Bollocks.
Okay, so that's Bollocks Scooby 545. Okay, introduce yourselves, everyone.
Okay, I am the one and only voice legend.
Victor Legend.
You're originally Crash Legend 25, bitch.
Go fuck yourself, yeah. Voice legend.
You can never escape from the Crash Legend you were back then.
Yes, I can. And I already have.
Not anymore. Anybody else?
I'm Macedonia, did a 15. I don't know why I'm yawning at the moment because I'm not even tired.
Just yawning for no reason.
I mean,
okay, repeat yourself. Though.
I'm Sun Tiger here.
Nice. And I'm just showing the ring. The rink? Why the fuck am I talking like Scooby Doo now? Fuck you, Stan.
The
ring! Shit. I'm talking like Scooby now. This is fun.
Like I said, Blaine Crash could be 454.
Real? That's me, guys.
Lol. Anyways, yeah, as I was saying, I'm just sharing the link around of a bunch of people, so yeah, that explains why it's taking a bit of time to get to the gameplay, just like last time, but, you know, it's taking as much time as it is, so you just gotta be patient.
Are you playing as Crash?
Well, here's the thing, I just fully upgraded as Crash, so I might start as Cortex this time. Of course, I'll still bring Crash back at some point. You know, it's funny because every time...
I'll bring Crash back.
Lol. Yeah, I see what you did
you
there.
You need to bring the orange dog back.
Yeah, that orange dog is really, really
cute. Yeah, orange dog to the shit.
Something else. Yeah, don't bring back that Bandicoot. Bring back that orange dog from the PlayStation.
The orange dog? Okay.
The orange dog. Yes, yeah. That's what I call the Naughty Dog vision. Crash, the orange dog.
Like the vicarious vision version.
Vicarious visions, wait, what?
Because he did not look like a bandicoot back then at all.
Yeah, he legitimately looked like a fox.
Like a fucking orange dog. Fucking fox looking.
Fox.
I always thought he looked like an orange dog.
That's what a fox is, anyway.
Yeah, that's effectively a fox.
Fucking Uncharted 4 made that joke.
Yeah.
Uncharted 4.
Yeah, even Nate made that joke.
Oh my!
A bandicoot looks like a fox.
Even they made that joke.
With Drake was hilarious.
I know. That's the funny thing. You know it's true.
The talk with Nathan Drake, the orange fox, was hilarious.
Oh, he said it looks like a fox.
Yeah, so your bandicoot looks like a fox.
I'm playing with a fox in jeans and sneakers. Bandicoot looks like a fox.
Wait, I died?
They didn't even look like jeans in the PS1
game.
Pretty sure
that bandicoots don't wear sneakers.
I died? I come back, is it?
Okay, anyone viewing the stream right now?
You should learn how to climb.
Oh yeah, you should learn how to climb.
I climb. I got places.
You got places to be.
I'm sorry, but Drake's commentary was priceless.
I know, man. You should learn how to climb.
You know the funniest thing? They actually make Crash able to climb in one game.
Yeah, that's the funny thing.
And like, It was in tag team racing. He was able to like shimmy across the ledge and stuff. It was cool.
Oh yeah, that was kick-ass. He was playing ads in the background.
Oh my god! Oh shit, my tweet blew up! Dude,
what the?
Multiple voice actors, fucking like James Smith.
Yo, Derek what blew Ryan, up now?
D. Houston? Bree Manning? Dave? Colleen O'Shaw? All of these are voice actors!
You're a bitch! Oh, so...
And it's only because I said something to Steve Blum.
What did you say to him?
You know, I just pretty much said, I've been watching your work for many years. I can't say enough that you spoke for all of us on that. Hashtag performance matters. And then, like, tons of people liked the tweet.
Hashtag.
Big name voice actors are liking the tweet.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that is mad.
That's crazy.
James Blum.
You're crazy.
You crazy it's motherfucker.
Steve Blum, otherwise known as David Lucas, is, yeah. The voice actor for Eikichi Onizuka, Tom for Toonami, Wolverine, Spike from Cowboy Bebop, and many other characters.
Even Crash Bandicoot in Nitro Kart.
Yep. Yeah, he's man. Even Crash. So that's crazy. He's voiced so many goddamn characters that it's insane.
Yeah.
And one of the most extensive fucking background histories in terms of Mugen voice acting.
From Sarai, yep. Shampoo.
You'll hear him in almost everything, in almost every dub, in almost every cartoon.
Look like a samurai.
He's somewhere, everywhere. Even in places where you don't expect him to be. Nobody expected him to be Crash, but there you go. He was Crash once, too. So he knows what it's like to be the Orange Bandicoot. You could literally go up to him and say, do your Crash voice from Nitro Kart, and he'll go, booyah!
Yeah, just kick his ass with awesome. It. It'd be epic. It'd be kick-ass.
Real.
Oh well, nobody will ever beat Rob Paulson, who got to be Jim Carrey for a lot less money.
Okay, so now I'm gonna switch over. Okay, Scooby-Doo, like, chill your jets there. Like, now I'm gonna switch over to the actual gameplay. So, yeah, for those of you who are actually watching the link, like, be sure to, you know, see how it's actually going. In terms of performance and shit. So I already posted the link like almost everywhere now.
Rare, give me a cheeseburger.
Oh yes. Join us in this beautiful stream. With Evo Doctor. With Evo Ham.
Okay.
And Evo Gel. And Evo Bread.
Oh my god.
Okay, now I'm just gonna... Before I... go back to redoing Dragon Temple after that massive fuck up. I'm actually gonna go around the island to see if to actually find some more stuff that I pretty much also overlooked. As also, I was playing this earlier today in under another like PSN, well not a legit right. PSN account, but as in another profile on the PS4 to actually see what I pretty much missed and. It's just pretty much a few more journals that I can pick up, or spell books, or whatever the fuck they're called. Right. So I'm just exploring around the hub world at the moment. I don't know if this is actually called a hub world, but it looks a lot like a hub world.
Hacker.
Hacker.
I never get tired of looking at this game.
Yeah, same. It's because, like... You know, Activision. They finally came to their senses.
It's a very pretty game.
Yeah, it's a beautiful
it's made
game.
By Vicarious Vision.
It's a pretty game.
Did I tell you the other day about the completely stupid nonsense that happened in the game shop or in? Maybe no people wouldn't hear it.
I don't anyway, think so, probably.
So yeah, anyway, I was in game and all that, and our local game, for some nonsensical reason, has removed all used PS and Wii games from the shop entirely.
What the fuck? Why?
Well, that's fucked up. Just,
they've removed all of them from the shop. They had three new Wii games on the shelf, and they were right next to the Wii U games, and they're only there because they were brand new. The thing where it gets weird is, so what did they replace them with? The shelving where they were had about 10 games on each shelf, and we all just used copies of Watch Dogs and Destiny.
Oh, that is fucked up.
So this extra space they've just got, they was using it basically to put some that takes no room up.
I'm sorry, but why does Cortex look like he's about to take a shit?
Well, why are you surprised? You know, this is the same shop. This is the same shop where people are actually queuing up to pay money to play Sony VR to demo it. You know, some of that should be free, and it's free everywhere else. But you know, game have to charge for it because game are that desperate for money and that nonsense.
Most probably, or they could have at least fucking put it on clearance.
Well, you gotta admit, this is the same game that, I'm not making this up, what actually put on Rat their Kingdom. Website, DS's Retro. They've got PS1 games in the same section as DS games. How does that make any sense? Yeah, that well retro machine called the DS, you know, that got games still in 2012. In stores.
Hello.
No, actually there was DS games released in 2012. Not many, but there was a few. Probably because most of the ones by that time have stickers on them saying they work on a 3DS on them, so...
Well, why wouldn't they? Like, the 3DS is backwards compatible, I swear.
Yeah, but not everyone knows that. So there's a big pretty thing on the label saying it. The thing is, though, you know how many Wii games and DS games that shop had on the second-hand part, on the used part? Well over 100 per machine. So they removed 200 games and replaced it with nothing.
What the... So now they're just empty shelves.
Sorry, I'm back. I just had to talk to my mom.
No, not empty shelves. Just shelves with like a few copies of the Watch Dogs and Destiny on them.
Okay, you said like they were replaced with nothing, so my conclusion was empty shelves.
They have to replace with nothing because not new stock has been put in on the replacement shelves. It's just more used games, but barely any used games. I looked at all the logic in behind doing that because that seems like a very weird thing to do at Christmas.
Oh, hello, old school gamer. Are you here because of Crash? Because if you are, you're looking at great old schooling evil.
I mean, awesomely heroic do-gooding.
And stuff. I found another journal. Or a spellbook, whoever it was.
I don't know how many of these in the game.
Oh my god, just go to the carnival games, Jesus.
You'll get your carnival game soon, don't worry, Stan. Don't worry, Scooby-Doo.
Why likes carnivals?
Well, you should have been in the last part, because we went to the Golden Carnival. I mean, Golden Arcade.
What? There's a Golden Arcade?
Yeah, there's an actual Golden Arcade here. Well, it's a level called the Golden Arcade.
Oh my god.
Yeah, oh my god, indeed. I'm just trying to find that place that launches me to that area where it's close to the E3 level entrance, but at the same time I'm not going into that level, I'm just going to like the platform below because I remembered there was another spellbook over there. And here it is. Man, this platform. Yeah, this really does remind me of Crash Bandicoot, this as well. Especially with the bonus round platform.
those kind of bug me about this game, though, in general. There's no quick select for the levels. You need to go through all this map area every time, and the levels aren't in a straightforward line either, so... Sensei
Dark Realm Discovered. So, did you beat the game yet?
Well, I beat over a week ago.
Oh yeah, Gary beat the game. Why do I keep calling you Barry? This ain't fucking Chucklevision.
Barry!
Hello there, Barry! To me, to you.
Hello there, Barry.
Prefer bacon.
So, I'm confused now.
Why? He doesn't know this British humor, so yeah.
That's why he's confused. I've seen that show, and I'm fucking American.
Yeah, that's the fucking funny thing.
I don't give a shit. I've seen it on channels like fucking BBC America as well.
Bitch, I don't watch British shows. Alone.
Go murder yourself.
Well, you should watch British shows then.
No Americans will understand.
You could kill yourself if you don't watch them.
Well, trust me, a lot of British stuff comes on that channel.
BBC America. That's so much irony.
Big Black Cock America.
Of course, ABC has a show about a British woman and a family. It was hilarious.
Okay, now to finally get back to that
evil
level.
Evil shall plague your life and your heart as I consume your soul as you play this delicious game.
Ruh-roh.
I might as well go to the academy right now since I got all these books. Skylander Academy.
Give me a Scooby Snack!
There won't be any Scooby Snacks at a Skylander's Academy. Or will there?
There will be pizza!
Doctor, you go yet about the book you found? I think he's gonna be pretty excited, like, give you a reward kind of excited.
And I take two cheeseburgers.
First Scooby Snacks, now cheeseburgers.
Almost forgot to tell you, everything's a Scooby Snack. Homelander ransacked the library, books were scattered all throughout Skylands. Besides, of course, dealing with the... I have to say this, food is the most amazing thing in the world. It would sure be nice to get our books back. If you find and put them in your travels, Skylander,
return them to me for a generous reward. Patience is not... My head is too big for my shoulders! This really hurts!
Wow, you mean somebody in America literally tried trading in Metroid Prime Federation Force and only give them $1 for it?
Wow, the whole of selfies. Are you fucking bullshitting me? And then place them in the
correct frame. Ronnie? And
all scholars
of the... Are you watching? Will get stronger.
The thing?
Yeah, the live
stream.
Oh, am I supposed to?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're part of the commentary.
That's what we're all here for, man.
That's the whole point, you're part of the commentary, so yeah, no shit.
Are we supposed to? No!
What's a live stream?
I don't know how to stream live, so I don't know.
Delicious evil. It's too bad my sex... I mean my best partner, Brio, is not here.
Well, Cortex did his head stuck in a pipe, so...
Oh yeah, that's true. Since Twinsanity, mind you.
It was hilarious.
Ah, evil scientist in a world!
Stuck in a pipe!
How could this get any worse?
Okay, Crash and Cortex are now up on the hall of selfies, like bosses. Why wouldn't they be? Because they're literally the two best characters in the game.
My god. How does he fart and hurts himself? I don't understand that.
No, it didn't hurt him, it stunk.
Yeah, he didn't like, yeah, he didn't like the fact that it stunk, like the that's smell. The point. That's funny, because... That's funny, because a bunch of people enjoy their own...
Hilarious.
That's funny, because a bunch of people tend to enjoy their own farts, from what I heard. Well, not enjoy it, but like, you know, prefer them to others.
Yeah, I already know one person who enjoys farting him.
Behold, my drop shot is much more deadly in this game in comparison to that other game. Ugh.
Is that dummy being the crab?
Okay, I'm just gonna get the fuck out of this place now. Oh, the stream, it really is going smooth. Oh, hey, old school gamer NR number one. I don't deserve to play as Crash? Why not? Yeah, let's not jinx it. One guy in the comment section says, I don't deserve to play as Crash, apparently.
Yeah, play as Sonic the Hedgehog.
Well, I've already fully upgraded Cortex, so it's not really a problem.
Dude, play as Sonic the Hedgehog.
If Sonic was a Skylander, then yeah, I could play as him here.
Are there people putting text in chat room right now on this live stream?
Yeah.
There's one guy named Old School Gamer. Gamer number one, however you pronounce it.
Yeah, Old School Gamer NR1. Yeah, he says I don't deserve to play as Crash.
I can't believe I try to pronounce it like that. I'm an idiot.
Vicar, go to a game.
Oh, you know Victor P.
Hey, Vicar.
He's not Victor P. Did he for nothing?
Hey, Vicar.
And I just leveled up to level 17.
Yeah, you gotta go all
Cortex.
The way to Queens and give me some Cambodian breast milk. Then after that, hell. You gotta take a midget. You have to take a picture with midget holding balloons.
Hey, Vicar.
Victor's a vicar.
I hate Roy so much.
What the Victor of Dibble?
How can you not say Victor? I don't fucking understand that.
Yeah, it's such a basic name to say.
What the fuck is a vicar?
Apparently it's these people at a wedding.
What the fuck is a hoey? What's a hoey?
A hoey? What the hell?
Yeah, that's what he calls Jorge.
Well, some guy's not pronouncing people's names properly now. He's like, you're spelling them incompletely.
English is bad. Very bad.
Oh, well.
He's American. Okay, he's American, and it's English is freaking worse than Andresian.
Wow. Well, actually, Andresian's English isn't actually that bad.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good for, like...
It's good for Serbian.
Yeah, it's good for a Serbian, but the problem is, this guy's American.
I know, that's the funny thing. This guy's American, and yeah.
Andresia is so bad, it's like worse than a Serbian.
Though. Yeah, Andresia sounds better than him. I'm sorry if you find it offensive that comparison.
I'm not trying to say that he has bad English or anything. I'm just saying, that's true. He's from a different country, and he sounds better than fucking Roy.
Yeah. No discrimination here, but still, like, it's just the point that we're making.
Dude, I love Coke
freaking
so much.
Daniel can speak better English than
Yeah, me. Fuck Daniel can speak better English, and he's from Israel. Okay, I finally made it to the Dragon Temple. Okay, anyways, back to the Dragon Temple, biatches. No, let's actually do this level properly this time, without any bullshit deaths from the fucking, you know, final boss. Let's try this without any cheap deaths this time.
We gotta do it this time. Fucking Spyro over there like,
fuck you, man! I'm not helping you. You're a pussy. And I'm gonna prove it by watching you die.
This is a dragon temple, so fuck you! It's not the bandicoot temple!
Your death is coming soon, don't worry, bro.
The
fucking Spyro, man. This dude never fucking runs. He flies all the time.
Well, he's got wings. He doesn't need to fucking run. He's a dragon. He doesn't need to fucking run. It's funny because he actually runs in the PS1. He actually ran in his actual, you know, PS1 and 2 games, but like, you know, he doesn't need to run. Just flies everywhere.
I know, but I'm so used to seeing Spyro run, fucking run. Fucking dude's always flying everywhere in the game, like, bitch. See, look at that. He could just fucking stand there and talk, but no, he's flying like a motherfucker.
It's time for
it makes more bridge. Sense than his old games where he just fucking walks everywhere and not fly.
Exactly.
Yeah, just can't be brave as any fire though.
Yeah, at least he's actually putting his wings to good use now.
I just like watching him run. It's always fun.
Anyway, I need to grab the bridge. Man.
You're weird. You want to see dragons run instead of fly?
Yeah, come on, man.
That's the opposite way. What the fuck?
That's like saying you want to see a fish walk.
Yeah. Well, fucking Spyro can glide. Fuck off.
But he can't fly.
Yeah, he can glide, but he can't fucking fly. That's the retarded thing.
Doesn't make any sense.
Care.
That's the whole retardation of it.
Why? I always used to look at that as a kid. I was retarded. Why am I falling to my death and I'm playing as a dragon?
I know. I used to laugh at that sometimes as well. I mean, that defies logic in a way. But then again, a lot of video games defy logic. But that, you know, that's taking it to the next level.
How old was Spyro in that game?
He's not even depicted as being a specific age, just as Spyro's a teenage dragon, that's it.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, effectively. Well,
his voice was funny and
his voice broke, so yeah, clearly.
One. Where's Nyeti Nork?
This is the best
voice. I'm gonna torture him on that, yeah, that
Tom
voice
Nanny's
is jokes.
Voice is just not cutting it, I'm sorry. It's not good enough.
Cause it's
not the parallels.
SpongeBob. Get the SpongeBob.
Get SpongeBob
and Spyro. SpongeBob and Spyro, really? Don't make me laugh.
That's Tom Kenny. It's practically SpongeBob and Spyro. When you think about it, it's also the mayor from Powerpuff Girls is Spyro.
Oh my
and
god.
And the Ice
really?
King.
Yep, and the Ice King is Spyro.
Oh my god.
And Veronica is Spyro, I'm just kidding.
Lol.
These puzzles are weird.
Yeah, they're fucked up.
Yeah, this is a weird ass puzzle. I hate these puzzle games so much.
What's you have to get all the purple gems together or something?
Yeah, you have to get them all together, then you have to get the actual green guy inside the portal. Well, you also gotta kill a red guy with a sword as well.
What the hell?
And you're doing this with the most Chinesey music in existence.
Yeah.
Just
this is like full on Asian music right here.
The red guy.
This music is so Asian-y, I'm fucking growing fucking gray hair, slanty eyes. I'm practically turning into Pai Chan from fucking Virtual Fighter. It's so Chinese-y.
Ta-da-dum. Oh fuck. Wrong move there. Wrong move.
Oh my god, you gotta do it again?
Yeah. See, you can't touch the fucking red puff. Oh, come on.
The great mighty poop.
Yeah, this is a Spyro game. You gotta do these fucking puzzles and shit.
Yeah, it's a Spyro and a Crash game put together.
No Spyro game is complete without a fucking mind-numbing puzzle like this.
Yeah. Or a brain-exploding puzzle for that matter.
That red guy hates you. Fuck.
That red guy's got something against me, man. Don't know what it is. Oh, finally, I got all of them.
Did you?
Yeah, I got all those fucking, what'd you call it? Now I gotta not get killed by that red guy, and it's gonna be really hard.
You said that, and then you died by him on my end.
Yeah, I know, I'm just like... Oh shit.
How okay. Do you get rid of him?
You get rid of him by getting just... by grabbing the other sword. And then you kill him with it by touching him. But you can only kill him when you have the sword, like... If you don't have the sword, he kills you. Or I could just exit like this. Fuck off, red prick. And I have a gem!
I have an energy gem.
Looks like I didn't need to kill that red prick after all.
Like, it just looks like two inner gems fighting.
I'm just like, fuck you, I'm out of here. The green guy's like, fuck you, bitch, I'm out of here. That man's cutting.
Jack's just like, you need to chill the fuck out, man.
You know, for a second I thought the TV had a broken front top back and tapes, but it said tapes.
And how many of you guys are actually watching the stream?
I'm watching.
I'm watching.
I'm in! I'm home!
Honey, I'm home! Where are my pants?
Oh, look at my beautiful home! Makes me want to masturbate with my socks.
Fucking hell.
Okay.
Where are you going with this, Victor?
Victor? That was Dr. Cortex. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh yeah, of course, Dr. Cortex.
Christopher Walken.
How's you? Don't lie. Who in space?
Christopher Walken.
You pop.
No, the actor, Christopher Walken.
Yeah, bro.
Hey.
Yeah, you're tapping those buttons really
hard. He keeps calling you Vicar. Yeah, I know. Here we go again with the Vicar shit.
Vicar. Oh, wait.
Well, hey, add Y to the call.
No. Not here. Live stream.
Yeah, man.
You don't want to hear extreme bitching in the fucking live stream.
Anyone add who to the call?
PC no, he's boy. Talking about adding Roy to this live stream. First of all, Roy has no history of crash. Second of which, all he'll do is bitch about himself for 24 hours.
Oh yeah, that'll be a fucking yeah. Waste.
After the live stream.
Yeah, man, leave that shit till after the live stream. I don't need any unnecessary bullshit of some random guy bitching about himself 24/7.
He'd be bitching about PC.
He bitches about himself too. About people don't like me, cause you're all issue some shit. Like,
what kind of logic is that? Yeah, save that for another time. Not my stream, okay?
Or any stream for that matter.
Yeah, any fucking stream.
No stream is deserving of that.
Yeah, no stream. Like, that retardation does not deserve publicity whatsoever.
Yeah, that, we give it to them, sadly.
Yeah, that kind of retardation is just out of the picture. A tube bazooka, nice.
For live stream events, it can be pretty funny.
It can be funny. It can be really funny.
41 damage. That's all I was seeing.
And or damage.
What's your level with ant hole damage? Anyway?
17. Is nearly. I'm only 3 levels away from being fully upgraded. I've already
but
purchased
Crash
all
is
his
maxed
upgrades.
Out, right?
Yeah, Crash is already maxed out. Like, I've purchased all of Cortex's moves and everything. I've completed his moveset. I mean, well, yeah, of course, apart from the soul gems for Crash and Cortex, which
you
actually collect in
from
Pimwampa Islands.
At the end of this game, Entropy is going to be so freaking mad because he got his staff.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Cortex actually took his staff.
I hope you don't mind. Fun
fact. It doesn't even look the same though.
Yeah, you see Uka was like, fuck you, Entropy, you're not worthy of the staff.
Look the same.
Yeah, that's the whole point.
It's a tuning fork!
Yeah, we know, but it looks different now. Because everything is different. All your orange dog memories are gone forever.
Shut up about that stupid orange dog.
Orange dog.
The orange dog's dead.
The orange dog and all his mayhem in history is dead. Comes next year, the orange dog will be completely eradicated and replaced with Crash Bandicoot. This means that Dr. Entropy will be in sexy, high quality graphics. Voiced by Victor Yates, since everyone is starting to fucking do that strike shit. I'm just kidding.
Yeah. It might as well,
they don't
you know.
Want a black man. I'm just
kidding. Yes,
yeah.
They do.
Then, they
got
like.
A black man puts Naku Aku. Yeah, just said nigga once. I'm offended. I'm just
it's my too. It might as well, you know. It's a.
How did the selfie thing work?
It'd be like a fucking one-man job, like the whole voicing of the characters for Crash Bandicoot Remastered, if that's the case.
But imagine how much I would make if I did do that.
You would hit it.
Yeah,
you.
How many voiceover artists would hate me for?
You'd be set for life. I'm not gonna lie. You would be set for life.
Yeah, because you would still be getting money over time, because the voice actors get money.
Yeah,
from that
because you're doing all these jobs. You're doing a job of a million people.
Everybody,
right?
Though. That's why I would make all the money.
Yeah, like, no wonder you want to fucking take over, you know, since they're all going on strike. Hang on, did I?
But yeah, man, I'll do all the guy characters, you know, just find a girl to play Coco and we're good. Even though I could do that too, when I become professional, I don't want to embarrass myself by saying that. That's embarrassing.
Yeah, man. Not cool, bro.
So,
unless it's really necessary on the last minute, be like, you need a girl voice, I can do it.
So,
yeah, it'd be like the last minute man.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, go ahead.
So,
I carry on.
The Incredibles 2 has been pushed up to 2018. Instead of 2019, and they push back Toy Story 4 to 2019.
Why? There's gonna be a Toy Story 4?
Why did they do that? Because of the voice acting thing?
I don't know, but that's what I'm seeing.
I thought the voiceover thing only applied to gaming, though.
Hang on, wait a minute. Toy Story 4?
Because if you realize, like, Toy Story, they can wait. Like, the Incredibles movie haven't had, like, a movie since, like, fucking
2004.
Yeah.
Hang on.
Honestly, I think that was a good decision.
Yeah,
yeah, but I'm offended because they haven't created the movie The Inigables. When's that movie coming out, Disney, you fucking cunt?
2024.
Yeah. Very funny. Disney goddamn racist. I want the first ever ghetto Pixar movie.
That'd be hilarious. Man,
call it Laquanda or something.
Imagine how subliminal that would be. You know, and as I was saying earlier, Toy Story 4, since when was this, like, news?
It's been news since, like, what, it was announced, like, in 2014, 2015? I believe.
Anyway, yeah, I think I'm starting to remember now.
Like,
yeah.
Toy Story 4 and The Incredibles 2, everybody was freaking out about The Incredibles 2.
Oh, yeah, I remember that shit and all. People were like,
oh my god, we're finally gonna see that girl's big ass again!
Elastigirl?
This time in full HD.
Mrs. Incredible.
Got nice Gluteus Maximus, and then Samuel Jackson will reprise his role. Where is my super suit?
Oh yeah, I remember that shit. Where is my super suit? Man, I'd love to see that again.
That went down in Pixar history.
What? Where is my super suit? That was fucking priceless.
He You have a lot of enemies around you, though.
Yeah, I know. This is fuckery. They pulled some Crash of the Titans bullshit right here, where all the enemies come at you and you hardly have a chance to attack them, like, all in one go. I mean, yeah, I know I can use my Sky Chi power, but still. I'm saving that for the boss. Because it's the wise thing to do.
That drop shot is way better in this game than
Quintet. Yeah, I know. So much better. They improved it a lot.
It actually has a purpose.
Yeah, a proper purpose. Instead of, like, you know, getting rid of fucking spiders around your legs and shit.
What upgrade path did you choose?
What's it called, I forgot what it was called, but I chose, like, the top path for Cortex. Hang on, I'll go back and check to see what it's called. Hang on, I don't think, like, I can see what it's called now because I already chosen it, but I'll say which ones I got. Entropy, Slow-Mo Flow, Insane Bolt, and Blaster Fracture. Those are the three ones that I've unlocked. So yeah, it's the top path. I mean, you can look it up, what it's called, if you want. Oh yeah, it turns out that fucking stuff is like entropies, because the first upgrade in the first upgrade path says Entropy Slow-Mo Flow, so yeah, what does that say about that?
I have never stopped time in this way. What kind of fuckery is this?
Or maybe Cortex did something with his Ray Blaster and Entropy staff in order to make his blaster actually transform into a staff or some shit. Cause that's one thing I clocked when I first unlocked Cortex's Sky Chi power.
Okay, I probably should have told you that there were more of those metaphorical dragon choice thingies.
Also can't get over how like Chi actually means power and technically Sky Chi power, they're saying they're technically fuck, I can't speak right now. Can't speak for shit today. I am technically. And whenever they say Sky Chi power, they're actually saying Sky Power Power.
Like,
some bullshit.
Cortex, you're now on my time, you little skunk! You will hand me my staff back! Or else!
Fuck off, bitch! You don't want none of this!
Yeah, then Cortex starts throwing all those, like, virtual, like, you know.
Where your hands
all that
at,
virtual
bro?
Shit at him.
Where them hands at, bro?
He'll be firing those virtual fireballs at him.
Cortex with Tom Sparrow.
I think I'll go for a nice bath in there. Hold on. Okay. Man, that's really good water though, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, I think this is the fucking point where I died as Cortex last time. Sons of bitches.
The furries are attacking Cortex.
Ouch! That did not feel good.
I'm just spamming mines across the place now, just to fuck them up. Get fucked, bitch. More like get raped. Level up. Okay, now I'm only two levels away from, you know, having Cortex fully upgraded.
If you switch Cortex out with someone else, will his health be the same when you put him back?
Yeah, it'll be the same.
Yeah.
I mean, you seen that example yesterday when they all died, so yeah.
Do, 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 do.
And that was depressing.
They should at least create checkpoints, for fuck's sake.
Exactly. This game deserves fucking checkpoints. It deserves, all the characters deserve life systems as well, not just Crash. Cause like, just the health bar alone won't cut
it. Crash?
It's not gonna do shit. Yeah, not just Crash, like, he's the only one in this game to have lives. As in like, multiple lives.
That's why it's probably the best to save for last in a circumstance like this.
Yeah. Most definitely. Yeah, he's perfect for everything in this game, really.
You got what I need. And you say he's just a friend. And you say he's just a friend.
Okay, gong challenge, bitches. I fucking love the music for the gong challenge. And that was originally gonna be like the music for Crash Bandicoot Sky Chipar with the yo-yo. And that still would have been awesome as Crash's Sky Chipar theme tune. But you know.
The gong
they
bell.
Changed it to Thumpin' Wumpa Islands.
Yo, I'll be right back. I gotta go for a minute.
Okay. Cool.
I gotta have sex.
You wish.
Oh, it's true.
That's nice. Yeah, keep dreaming.
Vicar's a gong.
Hey, Vicar!
Vicar's a gong.
Hey, Vicar!
Hey, Vicar!
Hey,
it's Victor Master Race. Welcome to Victor's Master Race.
Victor got his own Master Race? What the fuck?
Yeah. Well, you wouldn't know, you're part of the Scooby-Doo Master Race.
I know I am.
So yeah, this is news to you.
We all stick together because we're Scooby. We all are Scooby.
Yeah, go grab your Scooby snacks while you're watching this epic live stream.
No, he wants a cheeseburger.
He wants cheeseburgers, hot dogs, and Scooby snacks all in one go.
Oh, that'd be amazing.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I remember, you can actually buy Scooby snacks, man. I remember, like, back in the day I used to have them.
I bet you go look them up on Amazon right now, you probably buy some.
Long.
It was awesome when they sell Scooby snacks in like shops or shops.
Yeah.
It was so giggity.
And now I'm on the quote unquote Alpine Ridge.
Dylan returns. Oh. Because Dylan returns in 9 days.
Oh, Dylan's back. Hey, Dylan.
Dylan is still dead.
Yeah, that's just Dylan playing his fun again. But yeah, anyways.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome
back
to...
Look at the snowy mountain. Look at the snowy mountain.
Yeah, welcome
I'm
back
Baraka
to...
and I shall Baraka. Tear the flesh for your bones.
So welcome this back to fucking... You. What you call it? Alpine Ridge / Road to Nowhere or The High Road.
Oh my god, it reminds me of that so much.
Dun dun. Dun 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 dun.
Are you sure this is not a Crash game?
This is definitely a Crash game, alright. Just fucking look at it.
Look, you're running on the planet Techni, okay?
Yeah, this is effectively Techni.
Whoa!
Training with King Kai.
Yeah, this is Techni without the cars, you know.
Oh my god, someone's streaming
with
King
Kai. You will enjoy your time in Techni.
Your time in Techni.
I learned the spirit bomb from King Kai.
I'm back to grabbing the right bridges again. Shit.
Dude, I am Super Saiyan Blue.
What, Super Saiyan Blue or Super Saiyan Blue?
Super Saiyan Gold, bitch.
Super Saiyan, motherfucker.
I'm a Super Saiyajin.
I'm sorry, but the forms are so stupid. The forms are so stupid and super. They could just use regular Super Saiyan throughout the whole series, but they have to make it blue for some reason.
I mean, regular Super Saiyan, so there's like a double Super Saiyan. Wait, what?
Yeah, there's.
When you go Super Saiyan as a Super Saiyan God.
It's just Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan.
So Super Saiyan God wants to say something, wait, what?
It feels so stupid though. It's like you're just Super Saiyan with blue hair, and that's it. There's like nothing else.
He said that both he and Sasuke beat this game together.
Down the hole I go. Wait, what?
I want to see Super Saiyan 3 blue hair.
I don't care for
it. Can we get Super Saiyan 3 with blue hair?
Super Saiyan 3 with blue hair.
Probably be the most overpowered Goku you ever see in your life. You know, in Xenoverse 2, fucking Super Saiyan 3 may be powerful than Super Saiyan Blue Goku. It's hilarious.
What, you're playing that right now?
No, I was watching other people play Xenoverse 2. And Super Saiyan 3 is goddamn powerful.
Man, that'd be sick.
But it burns energy.
You can literally beat Super Saiyan Blue if you wanted to in the game. If you like fully upgrade your character, you'll be unstoppable.
Speaking of fully upgrading, Cortex is nearly on level 19 right now. Not long till level 20. The big 2-0. Well, in a way, like, this kind of makes sense. Hey guys, you know, like, in a sense, like, whether they're actually, you know, with the whole concept of upgrading to 20, and it's a coincidence that they're suddenly doing that right now, because Crash is 20 years old this year, and clearly this year is the 20th anniversary for Crash Bandicoot, so I'm not sure whether that's actually a coincidence, or whether they're actually making, like, all the Skylanders and Skylanders Imaginators upgrade to level 20 on... like at a maximum on purpose in order to also like celebrate
all the
Crash ones.
Upgrade,
I think it's just from the third game. Yeah, then it's just a coincidence because I think it's just from the third game. Yeah, I remember for the first two games it was only 10. Because I never had the third game, the fourth game, or the fifth game, so I only have the first, the second, and the sixth.
The only thing they've changed now is now the character creation ones and needs to have more sensor because you can actually go up level 20. They go up level 3 each different sensor figure out, so you can have them technically going up and get to about level 40 or something.
Yeah. But still,
it's a bit pointless because you just completely make the game too easy if you get that high level.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Like, level 10 is too piss easy to reach, you know. Especially since of characters like Golden Queen and Kingpin, you can upgrade them really easy, but at the same time, they're actually quite weak characters in terms of health. Although I'm not Although I wouldn't be surprised if, like, if this was actually the first game to actually make all the characters, like, have a maximum upgrade level to as level 20. I wouldn't be surprised, because then it would, like, you know, kind of be sort of part of Crash Bandicoot's 20th anniversary in a way, but still, that's not, clearly not the case in this reality, so that's clearly been thrown out the window since Skylanders Swap Force started the whole level 20 maximum upgrade level.
Oh my god. Mortal Kombat Armageddon is amazing.
Yeah, Armageddon's great. Deception was great too. Deadly Alliance was great. I love all the PlayStation modes on that game. PlayStation 2 era of Mortal Kombat games were amazing.
I think, is that what Dylan's saying?
I wonder if they're going to continue Skyline, or not Skyline, yeah, Skylanders.
Duh-duh. Who's continue Skylanders?
Seems difficult, because what, how they're going to improve it? I mean, if you've got customizable characters, what they're going to do, just make a sequel where you can make your own car again, even though the cars didn't do very well, so...
They'll come up with something.
Oh, no. Yeah, they probably will. I mean, this is business we're talking about, and this is Activision. Like...
I was thinking, how could they possibly top Mortal Kombat 9, and then X came out, so...
Yeah, that's a fighting game. You can never say
that. You can never say that, though, because, like, they'll always top their ideas from before. They'll always find a way to keep it in.
It's because technically Superchargers are worse than the previous game.
I wonder if Crash would work on the previous game.
The thing that annoys me, no, it won't work. It only works on the game.
It won't work on the previous game. I mean, the portals are only, like, backwards compatible with previous Skylanders. It's not, like, Skylanders from the next game that work on previous portals. Like, it doesn't work like that, because, like, each portal is designed specifically. Yeah, because each portal is designed specifically for the game and the characters they were made for.
So, like, let's say if you play as Crash in this one, then the next game you will be able to play as Crash.
Yeah, because they have backwards compatibility.
But in the previous, you won't be able to, because he wasn't made before then. They could program it to where Crash functions. Like, future games.
Yeah. It's nice how they make these fucking figures future-proof as well. You can use the older ones as well, but here's the thing, you can't unlock any Sky Chi power for them, because clearly Sky Chi power wasn't invented for those figures.
It's been the same with the entire series, like that, you get no actual bonuses for putting the figures from the older games in the new ones.
Yeah, there's no bonus. Like, you only actually
get
to...
You don't get any bonuses at all, apart from you just own the figure on this one.
Yeah, there's literally no bonus whatsoever. It's you just play them exactly like you do in the originals. Well, not 100% exactly, but like, I think they kind of change the move set sometimes. I think it depends on the game you're playing.
No, you can't change the move set.
Well, not the entire move set, but like. You know, I've seen Crusher play differently.
For the game, you can switch from one move set to the other one if you got so far into the game. But they removed that feature from this one because...
Really, Kyle? Really, Kyle?
Yeah. Okay, now I'm on the boss fight. On this level.
Bang!
And he's getting fucked over by Cortex's mines now. What a bitch.
The problem is, if they're going to make another game, is they have to have all the character creation parts from the previous game working in it, because if they don't carry over, yeah, that would kill the point of the game, so...
Wow, I just got a new follower.
This game seems obsessed with wanting to make
Thank
you. This game really seems to like...
You know, okay,
use character creators over regular figures anyway, so maybe in the next game we'll have any regular figures whatsoever, and it'll be just characters...
Whoever's the brand new follower, I really gotta thank you for following. Like, cheers for the support, whoever you are. I just got up to 66 followers on Twitch right now. Like, seriously, I can't thank you enough. It means a lot.
Does it?
Yeah, it does. Nice to see people showing support, you know.
Doesn't mean everything.
I mean, to be honest,
it could mean.
The game that this series started to get really messed up was Trap Team, because none of the Trap Team characters was playable in the previous game, in the next game. For some bizarre reason, even though they had a complete moveset, even though they had no, like, changing movesets, never removed them as playable. And that's where all the villains come in, and that's where all the villain figures in this game come from. They're originally characters you could play as in Trap Team, as Trap Scarlet, Trap Ones.
Imaginators.
Let your imagination go wild.
Hey, Vicar,
let your imagination go wild.
Traps. Skylanders game. Traps.
It's fucking vehicles, the previous one.
Skylanders Trap Team.
Trap Team. Skylanders Crap Team.
No, the annoying thing about Trap Team is most of my favourite characters added to that series are trap only characters, so they're not playable in the later games, they don't do anything in the new ones at all.
Wait, so the Trap Team characters don't do anything?
Not in the games after it, no. They don't do anything, they're not, they just give you a useless power up for a cat, for your cat, vehicle.
It's time.
Well, at least they do something. I guess, since you don't trap in that game, it doesn't make much sense to carry that over.
Yeah,
it kills the logic.
You put them in the base and he can
okay, he got killed by Cortex's fucking Sky Chi power, like a boss.
Oh, that. Well, why would they remove them all from the game?
Holy shit, I got 10 live viewers now. Yo, check this out, people. I got 10 live viewers now.
Unfortunately, I've got to go. Unfortunately, right. I gotta go grocery shopping and such, so I'm gonna have to actually go. I don't know if I'll be back sooner.
Okay.
I'm not well, hosting the call, so everything's
that's fair
fine,
enough.
But yeah,
you're probably not gonna be long either.
I'm not gonna really be part of the commentary for now. I'll probably be there like the next time, or I might be back sooner. Who knows?
Yeah, you're probably not gonna be long anyway, since you're only going to the grocery.
Yeah, but I also gotta do some other stuff, like I gotta shave my hair off.
Oh, fair enough.
My beard. And then I gotta go grocery shopping.
Alright, that's cool.
I might make it back. I might. It depends on how long you plan to do this.
Yeah.
Wait, are you growing it?
Well, it's already been like an hour going, and I've still got ages till I finish, so yeah. I'll probably be here a long time.
Yeah. This is Voice Legend, folks, and I'll see you probably in the next part. But everyone else is still going to be here, so enjoy your time, and also, let me know what you think.
No one likes you.
Go fuck yourself. But anyway, see you guys later.
Later, Victor.
Bye, Victor.
Okay.
Bye, Victor. I gotta love bye, that. And let's Victor. Okay, people, so Victor P. Diddy 8 has officially left the building.
No, his real name is Victor.
Okay, Dylan says, why offline? Never mind. Okay, yeah, so, as Victor clearly explained, he had to do some shit, so yeah. That's why, Dylan. What the fuck? Like, all these dragons chanting. All these chanting dragons. Oh, this reminds me of Spyro 2. In Colossus or some shit. Like, with all the chanting. Like, with all the chanting and everything.
Well, Skylander, now that we've brainwashed everybody, it's time to finally go after Chaos and take down that little pipsqueak once and for all. But first, why not try out the new Dragon Wings? See what it's like to be one of the cool kids.
Dragon Wings, hey?
Cool kids.
Oh, what do you know? Wow, this is actually awesome. Hang on, I can fly anywhere with this shit, what the fuck?
Imagine him just crashing into
I can. Hang on, let me check. Let me put that to the test. I can fly anywhere with this. Nice. Now, this is what you call real flying, not some next bullshit of Spyro only hovering like a few meters above the ground. Like since the first Skylanders. Now, that's what you call flying. This right here is what you call flying, and you don't even need to be Spyro. Like, way to eclipse Spyro even more, like, you know, way to make Spyro more of an outcast in his own spin-off. Well, at the same just time, this. Not exactly, because, you know, they actually gave him a spoken role, which is quite awesome. Well, yeah, there's still limits to where I can fly. Oh, and Cortex is actually fully upgraded, finally. Finally, to his full potential, Cortex is fully upgraded.
Cortex is overpowered now, he can fly and shoot.
Well, anybody can fly when they walk into these wings, so yeah.
Also, you just bizarrely turn into a ball when you go into one for no explanatory reason.
Well, actually, I'm not entirely sure if this level's even finished, you know. Glide to Skylands. Well, this looks like an awesome place to take a selfie. Wow. This is crazy, man. Like, when I take... Hey, but Gary, like, when I go into selfie mode... as Cortex, and I'm like right over here, and Cortex is just standing on nothing. He's just standing on midair.
All the dragons look stoned in this version as well.
Oh fuck you!
I'm a stoner.
Album's full, suck dick. Stoner boner. Well, that one's already in the frame, so I might as well take that one out. Hey, shut the fuck up, man. You're like butchering the call.
Hey! Language? Jeez.
Language, my ass. This is like an 18 plus rated live stream.
This is rated R.
This is rated R. Yeah, but in all seriousness. Sorry about that. In all seriousness, yeah, don't make stuff like noises like that. Cause it's ear rape. And it's also disruptive to the... It's not just that, but it's disruptive to the stream as well. Wait, I remember G-Man Rocks playing this part on his livestream series. Well, speaking of him, is he actually online right now? Because if he is, probably we could invite him to the call. You know, especially since Victor left. Well, especially since Victor just left briefly. In a way, this kind of reminds me of Rayman 2. Like, the way he's flying. I'm not entirely sure if you guys are getting the same vibe from it, but... That's the vibe I'm getting. In some respect, that's the vibe I'm getting. Yes, Rayman.
Is Rayman 2 on the PlayStation?
Yeah, it is. It's on PS1 and PS2. Oh. Well, PS2 is Rayman Revolution, but yeah. You didn't know? How could you not know?
I forgot.
Oh, you forgot?
Is that I...
You forgot?
I barely play Rayman. I play Rayman like a... Once in a blue moon.
Wow,
it's so weird how they made so many.
They should have a camera so mode. Version. As in, like, camera angle mode, where you can actually view so around many. You. That would be awesome. Raven.
So weird how they made so many versions of Rayman 2.
Yeah, I know, right? It's unbelievable. It's crazy shit.
and they made like one version of Rain Man 3.
Yeah, man. Well, technically there's a Game Boy version, but it's not that. Well, the Game Boy Advance version isn't exactly the same thing, but you know. Well, there's Rayman 3 HD as well, but it's still technically the same game.
I think he's talking about in terms of, like, ports.
Yeah, yeah, I know what he means. Like, because in some, yeah, some ports are actually remastered to, like, a certain point. Like, a certain degree, you know. Some, yeah, because for some ports, like, they actually remaster them from the ground up, in a sense. Like, change the whole level scheme and everything. Okay, I'm gonna check if G-Man's on. Oh, he's away. Alright.
Yeah.
Yeah, G-Man Rocks is away, so yeah. Every time his Skype is set to away, he's always busy, so yeah. That explains it.
G-Man is a busy man.
He's a busy man.
G-Man is a busy man.
Yeah. He gets busy all the time.
How can a person be like that? I don't understand.
Be like what? Busy all the time. What do you mean busy all the time, Stan?
I'm saying, how can you be like doing something ever? Take a break.
Oh, workaholic.
Yeah.
There are people like that, you know, they're real workaholics. I'm not gonna fire myself anywhere. Okay, I wonder where I'm gonna shoot myself. Well, not shoot myself as in, you know, but where I'm actually gonna cannon myself to. Gary, which is like the most sensible place like to fire to in terms of, you know, collecting everything, like which is like the best place to blast off to.
I can't remember at all.
Yeah. I'm just asking you because you completed the game, so
you just have to keep picking those dragon wings up till you get to the top pretty much.
Okay, I'll fire myself Wonder over wheel. There. Okay, that only took me over here. Well, it's nice how these dragon wings, like, give you the chance to fly back to the turret, so yeah, that's actually quite cool that we did that. I think I've been up there, I don't know, I'll try that.
I am dying waiting, to get though. Skylanders, right? It's really hard.
What, this Skylanders?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, this is the best one so far. Like, I'm not sure if any other Skylanders game will be able to top this, especially since Crash Bandicoot's involved.
I don't think any Skylanders game's gonna freaking
beat
Crash.
I don't think, yeah, no Skylanders game is gonna beat Crash. Like, Crash is too OP, you know.
The freaking new Skylanders is so hyped up because of Crash Cortex, isn't it?
Yeah, most of the talk of the new Skylanders has been about Crash and Cortex. Like, I'm not even gonna lie, that's what it's been like, you know. Even the way Skylanders Imaginators was actually announced, like, the first trailer this game ever got was through a Crash Bandicoot announcement at Sony's E3 2016 PlayStation press conference. Like, literally, it got its first official trailer through Crash Bandicoot. That says a lot. Like, if Skylanders got its own standalone announcement, then it would be a different story. Then Crash wouldn't be, like, the focus of it, you know. as in like the whole hype of Skylanders.
However,
actually, in a way, it would be at the same time because Crash is long awaited. So yeah.
However, from the advertisements that I see on TV, they're only just advertising Skylanders Imaginators, not even noting on Crash inclusion in there.
That's true. Well, that's because, like, you know,
then again, that's like
they're keeping consistent.
That happened for.
Oh, that's true. Though.
Well, again,
here's
that
the
happened
thing.
For like the Donkey Kong and Bowser one as well.
Yeah.
They
yes.
Only advertised the.
Yeah, it's the same story, and it's also understandable because, after all, Crash and Cortex are only having guest appearances in here. But still, like, I understand that. Also, understand in a way why they're doing that, because they've been doing that ever since the first Skylanders, so. Yeah, they want to keep consistent.
Yeah.
Wow, and you actually finished the level by flying into a mist. Wow. Oh, that's interesting. It's like it's got a Spyro type of ending in a way. Oh, hey Oscar, how you doing? Oh, the stream is lagging on your end. That's strange, because I'm actually watching the preview over here and it's playing fine.
Do you still have to talk like that?
No, everything's going back to normal.
And also, Dylan, please don't demand to read the chat, because that is quite rude. I mean, I understand you know. I understand you want your comments to be read out, but you just gotta be patient, you know. You can't really, like, demand a commentator to actually read out the comments. But yeah, I'm just saying how it is. Okay, now that we've got dragon wings, I'm just gonna fly over here to see what's on this part of the island. But yeah, I mean no disrespect by that, but I'm just saying, you know. It is what it is. And who has like a fuzzy background? Because I kind of hear some fuzzing going on in someone's background.
Tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
Yeah, just.
So.
Just carry on with your Scooby Doo shit, man. We don't want the stream to go dead anytime soon.
Believe me, man, this call seems dead right now.
Wow.
Wow.
Someone's echoing.
Yeah, someone is echoing.
Hey,
I can hear myself in someone's background.
Hey, Justin.
Dale.
Hey, Justin. I don't hear any background noises.
Well, not anymore.
Oh.
What is this?
Is that Super Dale?
Hey, Justin.
Super Saiyan.
See that picture?
Yes. What the fuck? Crash Bandicoot Remastered PS4 gameplay teaser, and he shows up and it has a picture of fucking.
I'm dying of laughter. That was so fucking funny.
Dude, freaking GameTech TV.
Hang on, what the hell? Hang on, what was that about Crash Bandicoot Remastered and a picture of a Game Boy games or some shit?
No. It was this PlayStation Legion guy named JTech TV, and his recent video is called Crash Bandicoot Remastered PS4 Gameplay Tease? ?
Fucking bullshit.
Just showing like footage, and then he's showing like footages from like. Skylanders and like talking like saying like, oh, these might be teasers.
Wow,
for, like,
fucking hell.
For like games.
Seriously?
Like...
Wow, is he that fucking retarded? How can you not, like... Does this look like fucking Crash Bandicoot Remastered to you? Like, yeah, this is totally Insanity Beach. This is totally, like, fucking... Or maybe he's getting confused with Thumpin' Wumpa Islands and thinks that's, like, the fucking remasters.
Like, oh, those things that they're showing, they're showing... Like,
but still, even that...
What theme, did you hear that?
But still, even what? That, that's just a fucking expansion pack for this game. It's hardly anything, like, in comparison to a full game. It's still, it's quiet. It's short, but it's big, but at the same time... Well, it's a big level, but at the same time, like, it's short compared to the rest of the game.
That's 23 dislikes.
23 dislikes. I'm not surprised.
You know how all the Crash fans are? They'll get pissed off.
Of course they're gonna get fucking pissed. Because, like, you know, you're just making clickbait. And then he sees it, and then, you know... It's not what they wanted. They watch it, then they see like fucking bullshit.
I'm sorry, but people should have seen that coming. It's Crash.
Oh, I saw that. I saw that coming because of the fucking thumbnail that he had. It was fucking Skylanders.
Oh yeah, that's blatantly obvious.
Freaking, there's so much shit. About, like, fake games and stuff, it was hilarious.
It is one thing about some people, I don't know how people won't be able to tell the difference though, because they're two completely different projects. Like, fucking Crash Bandicoot Remastered is a complete brand new project altogether. That's the main project for Crash Bandicoot's comeback, whereas Skylanders Imaginators is just a side project for Crash Bandicoot's comeback. I don't really need to go there, so... Yeah, anyways, you're gonna say something, Stan?
I remember 3 years ago, they did a PlayStation All-Star edit with Crash being in the game. That was pretty cool.
You mean Knack, right?
No, Crash. They add him in PlayStation All-Stars and put all the sound when you click on his name or something.
Oh, that? Yeah.
That shit was pretty cool.
Yeah, that's sick.
People thought that was real, and I was like, wow.
It was in the beta form, so it was pretty obvious.
Oh yeah, it doesn't get any more obvious than that.
Like, it had the 6 playable characters. It was in beta, and it showed my Crash on there. I mean, the video edit was pretty cool, but, like, people actually thinking that if that was real, oh my god.
I have not played PlayStation All-Stars in forever.
Oh.
It's been time since I played PlayStation All-Stars.
I still have the game. On PS3, it's just I haven't played it in a long time.
Yeah, true.
The sad part is that there was going to be a lot more in the game than what has been shown.
I'm sorry if I sound delayed here, but yeah. Like, were you actually talking about the whole Crash Bandicoot rumor in PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale?
Oh yeah, that guy who was like, leaking about like the Crash stuff and pretty much saying like the Crash announcement wasn't going to be too huge or anything, which I mean it was huge for Crash fans but not huge as in like a general, like in general, just hey, he's in Skylanders. And then the funny thing is too is like once when like the Skylanders stuff was being leaked about Crash being in there,
Crash.
He was like saying like, oh, one of the leaks have popped up. And the funny thing about that account was that he was getting his sources through other people. And he was just
Since this is a battle arena, I'm gonna be playing as Crash right now. Cortex has had a lot of time in the spotlight.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
But this is Cortex time to shine, not Crash.
Fuck Cortex. Wait, what? He's had a lot of time to shine. Wow, they're putting like some Entropy shit right now, like shooting these, like, what you call it, like lasers to jump over from the sides.
I love. Hey, you guys slip right in. You had some dirty quotes in that game. It was hilarious.
What game?
Slip right in.
Slip right in.
Hey, what game are we talking about?
PlayStation All Stars.
Sly's line in PlayStation All Stars. Slip right in.
Slip right in. It's been a long time since I've played that. Like, I got it on both PS3 and PS Vita. Man, Crash is just fucking tearing up this arena. He's like demolishing it like a boss.
I'm just like seeing like his movesets in Skylanders, and it would fit perfectly in All-Stars.
Yeah, actually would, you know. Like, here's the thing, like, they used an old design from Crash, so it was quite obvious that it was fake, like the image leak. Plus, as you said before, it was a beta. It was actually, you know, a beta, an image of the beta interface for the character selection screen, so yeah. It's obvious it was fake. Plus, like, the reason why Crash, like, yeah, it was a cool edit. But yeah, but also the reason why Crash wasn't actually in... Yeah, here's the thing, the reason why Crash wasn't actually in, what do you call it, PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale, was because, like, they... What do you call it? They, I think Super Bowl Entertainment, like, pretty much offered to include, well, they offered a price to actually include Crash, like, in PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale, but Activision were like, they were not willing to compromise. They were not willing to, you know, sell the IP for that price, so Sony couldn't get it back. But no, you know, now it's nice to actually. That Sony and Activision have actually, you know, formed a partnership back in 2015. So then they could put, like, a, you know, a brilliant Crash's epic comeback, like, in progress altogether.
Yeah.
And I'm glad they actually made that happen. And I'm really grateful that Crash Bandicoot is actually back right now.
The fight
again is Crash, Mario, and Sonic.
Hey, Justin.
What's up?
All hail Emperor Isaiah.
Yeah. Oh, God.
All hail Jeremiah.
What are you on about? Oh.
All hail Jeremiah.
He's our leader.
Hey, come on, like, don't...
Oh, my God.
Hey, come on, nobody's leader. If you, like, see certain people as your leader and you're just, like, a follower, then you've lost your way. I know you're joking, man. I'm just saying.
I'm my own leader, guys.
No, you're just a teenage girl.
You son of a bitch.
Surprise attack. Surprise attack. Of course you're joking, man. Why wouldn't you be? Like, I'll just explain, just in case those people in the chat thought you were being serious.
This is serious business, guys.
Serious business, man. It's taking me back to fucking those Spyro Speedrun Zero and all that crap. Man, just amazing to have Crash Bandicoot spinning infinitely. Like a boss.
because it's Crash.
Yeah. It's even better how he doesn't get dizzy when he spins as well. Like in Crash of the Titans and Crash Mind Over Mutant.
But if you upgrade him enough, then he won't be dizzy. He'll just spin infinite.
Fucking cupcake parts. Lol.
Like, Crash Tag Team Raisin, he spins infinitely. Like, you can literally tap the B button so much and he can still spin no matter what.
Yeah,
or
true.
Or the square circle button.
Well, technically...
He can literally jump while spinning. It was hilarious.
Well, technically in Crash of the Titans you can also spin infinitely, but you have to fully upgrade Crash. You have to actually fully upgrade his abilities in order to make that happen in the game. Otherwise, he'll just get dizzy every time you spin. You spin right round, baby, right round, like a record baby, right round, right round, baby. Who's playing that crap in the background?
Oh no, what? I'm playing a game that has music.
Okay. Extra life.
Pieces.
It's piss ass easy.
I love Crash's punk looking Crash of the Titans. It was awesome.
Yeah, it was cool and all, but he still looked kind of squashed up in there. I mean, I didn't mind his design for Crash of the Titans. It's just like Crash Mind Over Mutant made him look so much better. Although, like in the PS2 version, like, they had to remove his belt because of the PS2's limitation. Like, the game literally pushed, like, the, you know, the graphical limitations of what the PS2, like, can handle. So they had to actually refine it. They actually had to refine it. Yeah, they had to refine the PS2 version specifically. Okay, on what you're saying, I just finished.
Okay, if only if Crash, Mudra, Mutant, and Titans were on the PS3...
That would have been so much better. I was actually wishing that Crash of the Titans and Crash Mind of Mutant were going to be on the PS3 as well. Like, because the PS3 was out in 2007 and 2008.
Yeah.
I was wishing that would happen, but no. They had to still, like, stick with PS2. I mean, to be completely honest, like, they could have still made a PS2 version, but at the same time, they could have also made a PS3 version as well.
Yeah, they could have actually delayed Titans and Mind Over Mutant once they had the technology to do and, Blu-ray.
Yeah, and they could have made much better games as well. It would have effectively performed better on the Blu-ray as well, since, well, there's more space, and just allows more, you know.
Yeah.
It just allows more room on the disc, and like there's, and Blu-ray, and the speed that Blu-ray discs run are actually much faster, so, for all you know, on the PS3 the loading times could have been faster, but at the same time on the PS3 they kind of fucked up on the specs as well. Because, like, I remember people were preferring the Xbox 360 because of all that.
Yeah.
I don't know how I can't get out of this area right now. This is really weird, like... I defeated literally all the enemies.
Oh no. One of those glitches.
Is this a fucking glitch? What the fuck? No.
I hate those moments.
I've like cleaned everything. Everything is like clean out.
It happens in some games I play. It's like,
you know, I'm just gonna load.
This is gospel.
Wait.
Well, it's autosave anyway, so it's calm. So yeah.
Dingle Doll's the name.
Goku and Dr. Cortex. And Dylan's like posting more comments about Baraka. Yeah, I don't get that as well. I also don't get that, Dylan, like, why I was stuck. It's a fucking glitch in the game. But I'm finally out. I'm finally out of this fucking glitch fest.
You know the one thing that made me laugh?
Yeah, that's awesome.
It's hollow. Oh my god.
An evil king has set up shop in that town and cut off our access to some cake supplies. Double whammy! I suggest we take swift and immediate action.
Double whammy.
Flowers and Callie have found something in the dungeon over here. Could be an ingredient, could be a ghost. Can't wait to find out.
Okay, Dylan, so you mind posting comments that are not about Baraka and all that? Because, you know, it's nice to get some legit feedback every now and then. And it also gives everyone else in the call an actually a good... Oh, I can't fucking speak right now. It also gives everyone else in the core right now a legitimate reason to actually, you know, read the comment section. Ba-bum-bum-bum. I think I'll go the other way because that leads like past Thumping Wumpa Islands and all that. Or does this take me to the battle arena? Oh no, wait, it doesn't. This is literally the next level. Oh, it's another one of those fucking surprise attacks. Okay, head into Trouble Town. Trouble Town.
I remember it was good old days playing Crash Bash.
That was awesome.
Freaking thing that made me laugh in Crash Bash, how Dingle Dell laughs. Like, ugh! And even Super King! Oh. He's got bombs and mines, alarm sirens, evil goons, barricades and locked gates, mega locked gates!
He's even got some guy named Edgar! So, if you can help us out here, we'll be your best friend. All of us will. Okay. Well, it looks like there's something back here. Oh wait, no, there's not. They left a lot of room behind the spawn area of this level. But yeah, you're gonna say something, Stan.
The easiest thing to do is let the bombs off. Just blow them up.
Yeah, man. It's also sick and interesting how Crash and Cortex have like their own form of bombs. Like when you press the triangle, like they both actually throw bombs. That's another thing they have in common. Like Crash throws his TNTs while Cortex actually throws his mines.
That was hilarious.
Yeah, that's fucking hilarious as well. Take the key off this bitch.
Even though Crash is more combat based and Cortex is just...
Yeah, Crash is more combat based. It's pretty much like the moveset, you know, whenever he punches before he spins, they get that from Crash of the Titans and Mind of Mutant. And it's also quite sick because like Crash of the Titans and Crash Mind of Mutant were pretty much a platformer and a beat-em-up that mixed together like Jackie Chan Stuntmaster was. Which is no surprise because they were developed by the same company, Radical Entertainment.
I played Jackie Chan Stuntmaster a little bit. That game is pretty good.
Yeah, it's actually really sick. I still actually have the CD myself. Like, it came out like, when I was like, what, 5 years old or something? It came out in like 2000. I still have the game for the PS1. Like, how much of it have you played?
I play like the first stage.
Oh yeah, that's piss easy.
And I never beat in the world. I just played the first couple stages and that's it.
That's fair. Well, did you at least fight fight the first boss? You know, the fat chef.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's piss easy. I think it's epic the way you beat him as well, like, you hit him with a fucking mop.
Crash doesn't give a shit, he just spins.
Yeah, they're all getting demolished by Crash, like, relentlessly. And let me check which is the proper route. Well, turns out this is just an empty little area. Might as well open this. Wow, turns out I have to keep pressing R1 just to get this to move down. What a piss take. Why not hold R1? It'd be easier on our arms, easier on our fingers, easier on everything. Wow, I thought you can actually make it there, but turns out you can't. Turns out it's an area where you just can't access. Which kind of sucks.
Why is...
But yeah, as I was saying, like, Crash of the Titans and Crash... and, like, Crash Mind of Mutant both actually could have been on the PS3 and it would have worked so much better. And it's funny because yesterday I was playing Crash Mind of Mutant around my friend's house. Like, me and Bandicoot815 were both playing Crash Mind of Mutant on his PS2, and it's the first time I played Crash Mind of Mutant in ages. Ages. Why the fuck am I fucking up on shit right now? But yeah, it's the first time I played Crash Mind of Mutant in ages, and and now that I look at it on the PS2, like, actually, the game actually looks quite dated on the PS2, and we were playing on, and we were playing through component cables as well. That's like the best quality, the PS2, like, those are like literally the best quality cables the PS2 can ever use. And it's like, you know, it's, the game still looks dated, simply because it's, the game itself is pushing the PS2's graphical limitations. Whereas if you play on the Wii or the 360, it looks much better. Even the water looks much clearer. The water looks so amazing, it actually makes you want to drink water. Like, I could even try emulating the Wii version at some point later on. But since I've recently built my custom brand new gaming PC, which is fucking sick. See, yeah, I could try emulating that on Dolphin sometime later on.
I remember the good old days.
The good old days, man.
Crash.
Oh, this is a nice selfie. Let you take a picture of Crash of all these guys. Be a nice little family selfie.
Dude, the multiplayer in Crash of the Titans and My Immunes were awesome.
Oh yeah, I loved that as well.
It's like, you get two Crashes, and they... One's Carbon Crash, and one's just regular Crash, it was cool.
Oh yeah, that was epic. like Carbon Crash. I actually found Carbon Crash like an interesting model. I mean, I know it's pretty much the same model as Crash, but like, but you know, it's still interesting how you can view Crash in a different color. I mean, it's kind of, it felt like a fake Crash equivalent in some respect, but at the same time, not exactly, because clearly it's not fake Crash.
It was really cool though. He's like, he was white with green pants and like different color shoes.
Yeah, that was the awesome part about it. And you could play as him in the PS2 version of Crash Minor Mutant. And that was pretty much, but the only reason why was because that was the replacement for the graphical limitations of the PS2 being unable to support player 2 being Coco. Because I played the Wii version, and if player 2 comes in, Coco is automatically player 2. Same with the Xbox 360 version.
Couldn't you switch between Coco and Carbon Crash?
Actually, I think you could, but... Actually, yeah, I think you could. I don't exactly remember, but... You know, I never really, like... I didn't really put that much thought into doing that. But at the same time, you know... It's not 100% necessity, but it's nice that they included both Coco and Carbon Crash as playable characters. Something the PS2 couldn't handle. I mean, yeah, I know I could emulate the PS2 version and still make it look nice on PCSX2, but then again, it'd still be emulating all the dated graphics that had to be downscaled and to actually, you know, conform to the the suitability of the PS2 specs of how good it can run the game. I mean, it's not just that, it's not just graphics wise, but it's performance wise and sound effects wise as well. It can be a little bit laggy sometimes, and also at some points when some things actually happen, like explosions and stuff. Like, you don't even hear the sound effects go off. Like, that's how vastly downgraded the PS2 version was. Like, that's how far of the PS2's limitations Crash Mind Over Mutant, like, Crash Mind Over Mutant actually pushed. I mean, it's interesting when, like, you put these kind of things into perspective, because, like, before you wouldn't notice these things, like, when you play them at the time, but now, when you look at them, they just seem dated, like, depending on the platform you play the game on. Like, what do you guys think? I mean, this is my perspective personally, but, you know, it's interesting to know your perspectives on this as well. Like, for example, you look at a game that you played ages ago and it doesn't look as dated, but now you're playing a game like on a certain platform and it actually looks dated as fuck. Like, what's your take on that, people? If you guys are still there.
Oh yeah, those moments where you just play a game and it doesn't look dated, and then once when you go back to it, it's like crap.
Yeah, man.
It's like, I don't remember playing this. I remember it being much better. Holy shit.
Yeah, it's crazy moments like that that really make you think, you know, it actually gets you hypothesizing and everything. Give my regards to Chaos. Mm-hmm. It's also funny because Crash Mind Over Mutant could have actually been on the Dreamcast as well, because telling by the PS2 version, it also looks like Dreamcast graphics in a way. It was part of the same generation as well, but Sega clearly got kicked out of the console business faster than the rest. But if they weren't, Crash Mind Over Mutant could have you know, potentially been on the Dreamcast. And I'm not sure if it would have worked out as great, but you know, there was some aspects that the Dreamcast was actually kind of superior on in some sense. Like some of the games on the Dreamcast that were also on the PS2 were actually, you know, running at a much better frame rate and everything as well. Because, like, you see, take Rayman 2 for example. Like, Rayman Revolution for the PS2 is basically a remastered port with some parts completely remade from the ground up, and it can't even achieve like a full 60 frames per second frame rate. Like, there's always gonna be some points where there are frame drops within the game, whereas on the Dreamcast there's like double rendering, so it's like making the game run faster than it usually does, like on the than it usually would on the Nintendo 64. And it's running at like 60 frames per second, but it's like double rendering because it's much faster. And also, the Dreamcast version actually has a widescreen support. It actually has a widescreen option. So yeah, the Dreamcast version of Rayman 2 The Great Escape actually does have widescreen support, whereas Rayman Revolution on the PS2 doesn't. Which is really odd. And that's why a lot of people tend to believe that the Dreamcast version of Rayman 2 The Great Escape is the definitive version of Rayman 2 altogether. I mean, even Victor would tell you. Mate, he owns it himself. Like, I'm still yet to get it, but yeah, I know, it's not gonna cost that much. But I'm just gonna give it a little bit of time right now. So yeah, it's also crazy how consoles, like, from, you know, consoles that didn't make it as far as current consoles right now actually had better potential than consoles that made it further than they did. It's even crazier when you think of it like that, really. Like, in a sense, it is crazier.
Holy.
I have to keep talking to this guy now every time. Wow, okay, back to the arena battles.
Bobbers and Callie have found something in the dungeon over here. Could be an ingredient, could be a ghost. Bet you can't wait to find out.
I thought this game would be like dirt cheap, but no.
Well, Skylanders Imaginators.
No, Folklore.
Oh, here's the dungeon. Oh, Folklore.
The PS3 game that came out in 2007.
Mausoleum of Madness. Nice. Hang on, what game I was just like zoned into playing my game, you know? You said it was like a PS3 game that you thought it was gonna be dirt cheap. Like, what was it?
Yeah, I thought it was gonna be like cheap because it's like it's been like almost 10 years since it's been out.
Well, Dylan in the comment section is actually pretending to be Kratos right now. Like, fucking hell. He's like, I will have my revenge, cool pro 195, and you will die. Yeah, I'd like to see the day.
And
that won't be happening in 10 years time, so yeah. We got a long way ahead of us. You got a long way to go, amigo. Hey, nice try with that one, pal. Do you know there's a key there already?
Don't you have a son to take care of?
Yeah. Yeah, Kratos.
Oh.
Was that you, Stan?
Yeah.
Bet you had too many hot dogs to eat at the carnival, I take it.
Yeah, I got some carnival dogs and carnival burgers, carnival everything.
Cause we like carnivals!
I got key crack too.
Nice. Candy crack.
Key crack horn, I don't care.
Lol.
Oh my god, they have a haunted level theme in this game.
Yeah, I'm playing it right now.
Well, spooky scary.
How long do you have to go through this game?
Yeah, this really does add up. I'm not entirely sure. It's gonna be a few live streams, I'm telling you that much. Well, I know that much anyway.
Is this game really that big?
Actually, it's quite a short game. It's not really very big really? In comparison. In comparison to previous Skylanders game, it's actually not that big. And I've only beaten the first one, to be completely honest. But I've also seen others, like other Skylanders games that came after the first one. And, like, each level in any Skylanders game would typically be, like, an hour long. At the very least. Or at least 30 minutes or 1 hour long. It was like that of me of Skylanders Giants as well when I was playing it. As a matter of fact, like, back in 2012, I actually started a Let's Play on Skylanders Giants for the PS3, but I have never got a chance to finish it. But I'm still, like, considering going back to it because I actually want to finish it off instead of just cancel it, because it just feels unprofessional to cancel a Let's Play in my eyes. And that's how I feel about it anyway.
Yeah.
And you know, since like you guys are actually helping me with this live stream series, like it would be nice if, you know, you guys could actually, you know, help me out of the Let's Play as well. I could potentially keep this call for like, you know, to actually finish off that Let's Play in a new light as well. Since what, this has been quite a hyped up live stream series that I'm doing. And this also happens to be a Skylanders game, so I don't know, maybe it'll kind of bring some of the hype back. Especially since, like, what, it'll bring, like, more topics up for discussion, to especially, like, filler topics, you know, in order to make it, like, the commentary, like, less dead and uninteresting, you know.
Oh, yeah.
I need a new PS3 controller.
Yeah, so do I, come to think of that. Cause like the only other controller I have is like a wired controller. I've only got a 6-axis controller and a wired controller, and that's it. I actually still need to get like a wireless DualShock 3 controller. Well, not just for the sake of getting a DualShock 3 controller, but also because I actually need like another controller that's wireless, cause wired controllers suck nowadays. Especially when they make the wires so fucking small when you charge the controller, it's so fucking stupid. And they did the same fucking shit with the PS4. That's one thing they should do with the PS5, like, they shouldn't make that same fuck up. They should make the cables longer for the PS5, and like, I don't know what the next Xbox will be, the Xbox 2 possibly, by that logic.
Unless you can just, well, Microsoft can't count, so anyway.
Yeah, true, they can't 100% count. I mean, the Xbox One S kind of seems... I mean, the Xbox One was already fucking... The Xbox One itself was already like, what? They fucked it up on the advertisement. So,
the all-in-one system. That's why they're calling it that.
Yeah, it's all in one. But yeah, it's still a stupid name altogether. Like, Xbox One, you know. Like, we get the fact that it's all in one, but still, it's still no excuse to call it the Xbox One. Like, I remember hearing rumors that, or seeing a bunch of rumors that the Xbox One was initially gonna be called the Xbox 720, which is kind of like, you know, a sequel based to the Xbox 360. It's like a sequel based on the Xbox 360, and I personally reckon Xbox 720 is actually a better name than Xbox One. Because, like, Xbox One, like, you hear that name and you think, like, wow, like, really? Have you forgotten about the very first Xbox that ever came out? Like, the big, like, the massive original Xbox, the grandfather of all Xboxes. Like, are you fucking bullshitting me? Yeah, I still have my original Xbox with me as well. It's fucking awesome. It's still a fucking awesome console to this day.
I need an OG Xbox, bad. I love the OG Xbox.
The OG Xbox is OG, you know.
Yeah, G. Word.
It's OG, my G. Okay, I know I'm gonna have to delete another photo from the gallery, but you know, it's not much of a problem.
Scoop up, 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 up,
up, up,
up, up, up, up, up.
Good job.
Cool.
Oh my god. Look at that face.
Why is there a limitation to how many pictures that you have to take?
Yeah, I don't get that either. Fucking limitation on the amount of pictures you have to take. That's fucking retarded. I mean, come on, that just wastes time. That makes the player waste time on having to go back to the gallery and delete photos. Like, what's the point in that?
Cortex is a tech sorcerer.
I hope, Skylander, it's me, Blobbers. I wasn't able to find any rare treasure, but while waiting here, I did manage to invent a brand new form of cake sprinkles. Can't wait to put these babies on the market.
Man, I can't wait to get this game. I would probably have hours of fun just playing as Crash.
Oh yeah, you're certainly gonna have a lot of fun playing as Crash. You know, if you actually get bored of playing as Crash, then I'm sorry, but you have to be one of the most boring people on the planet. And that is saying a lot, because Crash Bandicoot is just too fucking awesome to be considered boring.
You gotta be one of those first-person shooter guys, if, like...
Yeah, you gotta be one of those fucking first-person shooter fags right there. Who just do nothing but fucking, you know, snipe 24/7 and all that crap. I'm on the surprise attacks. I'm in a surprise attack section again. This better not glitch out on me. Anyways, what were you saying?
Or maybe it's because some people don't really find it interesting.
Yeah, true. Well, some people don't find it interesting, but yeah. Well, if you don't like Crash, then more power to you. I respect you for your opinion, but no need to go overboard about it, you know. No need to bash it. Yeah, you see, see, I'm cool with that. More power to you. You like Spyro better. I mean, I don't mind that. At least you're, like, not being a dick about it.
Well, I'm not talking about, like, all Crash games. Like, no, like, I really do like the other games. But the first three games I can't get into are the Nightfall games.
Well, at least they're being remastered.
Yeah.
We have to fix controls and such. So I guess...
Oh yeah, there's a lot to fix. Especially since all these voice actors are on strike. It is kind of a piss take that Crash Bandicoot Remastered is being delayed at the same time. But still, at the same time, it gives... Yeah, they announced it being delayed as well. I saw an article about it. But, you know, at the same time, it gives, like... At the same time, it gives Vicarious Visions more time to, like, work on the other parts of the Crash Bandicoot Remastered project in order to actually finalize it to make it even more... Well, close to perfect. I wouldn't say 100% perfect, because nothing can be perfect. I mean, it doesn't matter if it's perfect. It doesn't have to be perfect. As long as it works. As long as it sells. As long as it's just a wonderful... As long as it's advertised properly. And as long as it's, like, you know... Some brand new Crash Bandicoot content that I can actually, you know... play and enjoy, like this, for example, or potentially even better.
I am perfect.
Fuck you. Scooby-Doo's perfect, Wiggle. Just one more cake to go. Town overrun by chickens. Sal is over there trying to get rid of the chickens and save some eggs for our cake. Can you give him a hand?
Town over there trying to get rid of the chickens.
Trying to get rid of all the chickens.
I love that dude's voice. It's hilarious.
Yeah, he's fucking jokes.
I'm sorry, but the voice works so well in that game.
I swear I already fucking been there. That is weird as hell.
Soda pop.
Trouble Town? That is strange. I swear I've just been to these two levels. This is fucking strange.
Trouble Town.
Rebel Town.
Trouble Town.
Hey girl, what's up? The infamous Captain
Clark has set up one of his franchises here. The infamous Skylar.
The infamous Skylar.
I have an idea that may scare them off. Music. Chickens hate music. Especially crazy angry chickens.
So,
if you would be so kind as to lead me around while I create as much of it as possible. They might just be able to scare off the chickens and force Captain Cluck to relocate.
You see, here's the thing, Dylan. Hey, here's the thing, Dylan. I'm actually saving the Thumpin' Wumpa Islands level till last because I'm actually playing through the main story of Skylanders Imaginators first. And to be completely honest, this is basically all these levels are effectively like Crash Bandicoot levels in a way, so yeah. It's no surprise. So it's no surprise I'm playing the campaign as well. Well, not fucking campaign, this isn't a first person shooter. Like, you know, the story, I mean. All these
campaign,
chickens, man.
Story, single player, solo, whatever.
Whatever the fuck it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the same thing, but like, you know, first person shooters always call it campaign. Man, all these chickens, they just reminded me of all the later Crash games. Well done. Like from the late 2000s. But there are plenty more
down the stairs. Follow me. PlayStation VR.
PlayStation VR. Now imagine Crash Bandicoot on the PlayStation VR.
I heard some good things about it.
Yeah. Now, I've actually seen GameSpot, like do a live stream with PlayStation VR and they are playing Batman Arkham on VR. Like, I think it was Batman Arkham VR the game was called, but I'm not entirely sure.
Yeah.
It actually looked quite sick.
You're playing as Bruce Wayne?
Batman. Batman.
The funny thing is, though, I've been joking about, like, Gravity Rush 2 being on the VR, and apparently, from, like, one of the live streams that I saw of it, which I had to wake up, early in the morning for, but it wasn't that early, but, at the beginning, it showed, like, someone playing Gravity Rush Remastered with the VR headset. Like, it just showed them having on the VR headset. And I was just like, wow, I fucking joked about it, and it's actually happening. What the fuck?
can't imagine the VR, man.
Gravity Rush is gonna support VR.
Yeah, apparently.
Sony wants to really sell that VR system.
Yeah, the VR's actually selling for the PlayStation VR is actually selling for like over £300 at the moment.
Well, yeah, it sounds fun, but I'm not gonna be playing it over and over.
True.
I mean, I'll just wait.
Yeah, I'm not gonna buy it straight away. No. I mean, give it time. It looks sick and all, but you know, give it time.
Yeah, I wonder if you can play the VR Uncharted 4.
Oh god.
Hard mega chickens, fucking hell. Man, now they're having an obsession with chickens and shit.
You know, at least the chickens are attacking you.
Yeah, true say on that. At least they're not attacking me. Actually, I don't think I've been here before.
Oh, have you?
No, I haven't.
No, you haven't. The new politics.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Aren't you fabulous? So.
Not much. I was just drawing shipping stuff.
Noise.
I'm pretty sure Victor's told you so much about that.
Most probably.
As he.
I hear the fat shit now. Yeah, the stream's still live.
Oh, okay.
And by the way, Dylan, that won't happen in not even 10 or anyway 20 years, to say the least. Like, there's no way anyone's gonna kill me and become Cool Pro 195, because there's only one Cool Pro 195.
It is I,
motherfucker. And that was piss easy. All these chickens are actually reminding me of Crash Bandicoot 3 Warped, to be completely honest. Because, like, that was the first ever Crash game to introduce chickens, like in the medieval levels. This even looks more like a medieval setting, to be completely honest. And I don't know if I'm gonna defeat Chaos today or not. I'll see. It might be in this live stream or it might be in the next live stream, but all I know is that I'm over two hours and a quarter over in this live stream already, so yeah. There's a chance, like, I might defeat Chaos in the next live stream. Okay, so that's 5 cake parts collected. Ba-boom. Surprise attack. Man, I should stop hitting these people because then I don't get all these random bullshit surprise attacks out of nowhere.
Surprise attack!
Surprise attack! No, but the surprise attack challenges aren't even a fucking problem. I mean, the only thing I'm concerned about is whether the game is gonna glitch like last time. Like, not exit the arena. Well, actually, this isn't technically an arena, but, you know.
Huzzah for the Skylander! And, ooh, those baddies had a chest full of gear you might be interested in.
Tired already? What time is it over there?
It's just 7:23.
It's 7:23
today. Or AM or PM?
PM.
Okay, that's still early.
I'm turning up on Tuesday.
You're turning up on Tuesday? What do you mean by that?
Stan,
what do you mean by that?
Yes. Nothing.
Okay.
Don't you turn up on a Tuesday?
You turn up on Tuesday. Okay.
It's from a song.
I don't know if I remember or not, but I don't know, it depends.
Turn it up on a Tuesday.
Jetpack's been working on securing more cake supplies, but has a problem with an evil creation tron. Help him get the supplies and maybe tell me what a creation tron is later. Stealth Elf is wondering if you might give her a hand in winning an arena battle. Cake ingredients are on the line.
I swear I've already won an arena battle, though. That is weird. Oh, at least it's only directing me to here now. It's mainly going there, but I'll go to the arena battle. Oh yeah, now, well, I've been playing as Crash and Cortex a lot, so now I'm gonna switch to Kingpin. Time for Master Kingpin. Stay frosty. Here, now we're coming on as the Hench Penguin. He was nearly up to level 10. And you know what's funny? Like every time, in the live stream, in this series, where I also play as other characters, apart from Crash and Cortex, there's always gonna be that one guy that dislikes the upload. There's always that one guy that dislikes the video, which is fucking retarded. I mean, it doesn't bother me, but it's just retarded how that happens, you know.
They just want the dislike just for the sake of disliking it.
Yeah, either that, or it's just one of those people who just want to see Crash and Cortex and simply don't give a fuck about any of the other characters.
Hello,
I mean, I'm just giving them a chance to at least have some contrast in this live stream, at the very least. But, you know, at the same time, it doesn't really bother me at the end of the day because, you know, it's their own time they're wasting by coming on my video just to dislike it, you know. It's their own problem in the end, not mine. If anything, they're giving me one more viewer by doing that, so... For those type of people, I'd like to say thank you and fuck you at the same time. But at the same time...
Okay.
Even though I give no single fucks whatsoever. On that faithful day...
I still want you, but I love you.
On that faithful day, I give... On that faithful day, not a single fuck was given. After all, it's the art of not...
fucks were given.
Yeah. After all...
I love the expression now.
Well,
no fucks were given.
Yeah, that's a good one. And I've certainly mastered the art of not giving a fuck, you know. I'm like a sensei in that area. Can even ask Crash, he's a sensei. Like, even ask Cortex, he'll tell you.
Why does Crash care? He smiles at everything.
Exactly, if anything, like, he's the emperor of not giving a fuck. He's the emperor. He's literally the emperor of not giving a fuck. He just smiles everywhere without giving a single fuck about anything. Like, even in Crash Tag Team Racing, like, you know, he just does something crazy and he just gives no fucks. Especially, like, you know, when he taps the gem. Like, you know, that black gem that Ebenezer Von Clutch has to keep him powering. And he's like, oopsie, or some shit like that. And then he puts it back in. And then, like, at some point he causes... There's some destruction going on, but then, like, he just takes off without giving a single fuck whatsoever. He just takes off in his racing car with no fucks to give. Man, I still gotta keep away from these pricks. Yeah, I love the randomness as well. Nice. I repeat what you were saying, Stan, because Skype was cutting you out.
I just love all the random scenes that Crash gave himself into.
Yeah, but dioramas and shit like that. That was always fucking priceless.
Like Engine was the taxing thing, and Crash was just messing around with the lever.
Yeah. Well, that was too funny, man.
He freaking... like, force the lever down, and the freaking car just, like, slammed the engine into the car.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. You just span into the fucking lever, or, like, the pole that keeps it up, and then the car just falls on top of the engine. That was too fucking priceless to even not laugh at, you know. It's too priceless to even stomach for some people. Too hilarious to even swallow.
Crash had no logic in that game. He literally spinned himself into explosives and blow the shit everything up.
Yeah. Even when, like, in that diorama called Nature Strikes Back, he, like, spins a fucking tree trunk and then it falls on top of him.
Which also happens to be our battle arena. But just like I promised, here is your reward. Boy, I sure picked the right person to represent me in a trial of combat, huh? And besides being found not guilty of all those parking tickets, we are now one step closer to finishing that cake for chaos. Pretty sweet.
Also, this battle arena was all because Stealth Elf had parking tickets, and now she's like found not guilty because I beat all these pricks in a fight in a massive arena. It's some crazy story they thought up for this game. Okay, two more cake parts to collect, and I think I might call it a live stream by then. I think I might call it a night after that.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely.
Guns hole.
Guns hole.
Gun hole.
Gun hole.
I'll shoot everybody with my gun. I will shoot you with my bazooka.
Yeah, bazooka's the best way to shoot them. It's the best way to shoot people. And fruit bazooka's the best bazooka to use, you know. Fire Wumpa fruit. The most explosive projectile known to bandicoots worldwide.
Turning up.
Anyways, what do you guys think of all the rest of these Skylanders apart from Crash and Cortex?
I never really seen in any of the other ones.
Now, I mean, what are your like first impressions of Kingpin right now? As you see me playing as him, clearly. You there, Stan?
Yeah.
Okay, like, what are your first impressions of Kingpin?
New Sentinel weapon.
Oh, yeah. Why is Twitch messing up on me?
Hang on, did you just refresh the page?
Yeah, refresh the page is not going on.
Okay.
I feel like Twitch doesn't work sometimes.
Yeah, it's probably your computer, probably your connection, if anything. Hang on, I wonder. Oh, really? So I always gotta go and talk to that guy every time I wanna go to the next level to collect these fucking cake parts. Are you fucking for real? Hey, wow.
Kingpin.
I mean, for me personally, like, the first impressions I got from Kingpin is that he actually reminds me of the Ratsicle and the Spike from Crash of the Titans and Crash Mind of a Mutant. In terms of, like, the way they both attack. Like, they both have spikes. Like, they both, like, leave a trail of spikes in front of them. Like so. But it reminds me more of the Ratsicle because of the icicles. I mean, yeah, the icicles are spiky, but still, like, the fact that they're icicles just reminds me more of the ratsicle than the spike.
The only two characters I saw so far is Kingpin and that
Golden
Girl.
Surprise attack. Wow. I think I have a habit of slicing that poof that gives me a fucking surprise attack. Well, then again, it's beneficial for me because then I can upgrade K Kingpin much quicker.
It's just people too busy using.
Wow. Yoing
yoing. Yoing
yoing. Dude, those dudes in Spyro 2 were funny.
Oh yeah, they were jokes.
The freaking they make this song and they lift stuff with their minds.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what, like, the chanting back in the Dragon Temple reminded me of. Like, you know, when you saw Spyro and all the dragons chanting, like, earlier on in the live stream. If you actually remember.
Yeah. Where? York.
Some bank robbers have just robbed the bank! Who saw that coming?
Okay. Turns out these are places I have to backtrack to. Which is kind of strange.
Well, howdy there, Skylander. So glad you saw fit to visit this dungeon of mine. But despite my cheery disposition, I do have some bad news to report. Old Chaos has wrecked the entire place for demolition. Let's build one of the Chaos Martins. Not only do we not need another sprawling chain store with cruel employment practices, I really don't want him blowing up my dungeon. So if you would be so kind, would you please destroy each and every one of these detonators before the place explodes?
Can I destroy you instead?
Okay, Dylan. Okay, Dylan says, but when you fight Chaos, get a lot of Skylanders because the final boss is like the Spyro's Adventure final boss and a lot of your Skylanders will die a lot. But that's good, I still have a lot of Skylanders. It was easy with all my old Skylanders. Well, like, I don't know, I might buy more Skylanders, like, you know, in this series, but at the same time. You know, not. It depends, really. Depends how I'm doing for money. Not just that, but, like, it's when to get him as well. But Crash is really powerful, so I doubt that he would die straight away, especially if there's multiple lives, so. Yeah. I can certainly see Crash, like, surviving a lot. Now, I've got to do something about destroying detonators. I've got to destroy all these detonators inside Mag's mansion or whatever the fuck this is.
Xenoverse.
It's like we're doing fucking chores in here. This is definitely like Spyro at the same time. Fucking cunts. Like, they're coming at me out of nowhere when I'm just trying to detonate these bombs.
You come at me, bruh.
What you gonna do?
What you gonna do, bitch?
You should just sit on
this dungeon. It's not fucking mansion, it's a dungeon. What am I on about? Don't know why I said mansion earlier. Wow, looks like they all these detonators have different controls in order to detonate them. Fucking
Skullgirls. I have
Bitch,
played
please.
Skullgirls in front.
Skullgirls, what the hell?
It's a 2D fighter. And it's all about that base. No charcoal.
That bullshit.
Can you take me higher?
More like it's all about that Scooby, no Shaggy. Wait, what?
Scooby.
Scooby. Fucking hell.
I'm a great bomb. Chaos loves me.
Oh, jeez.
Self-destruction coming soon.
There was a
dungeon near you.
Finally got this kill.
And the old Scooby-Doo was still the best.
The original theme, man.
When they had the Scooby and Shaggy movies instead of like Fred, Thelma, and Daphne.
Yeah, man. I mean, I didn't mind that either, but you know. Okay, just one more.
Wait,
one more bomb to detonate.
It would be pretty cool if they brought Scrappy Doo back.
Oh yeah, I remember him, Scrappy Doo.
I'm Scrappy Dappy Doo! Let me out!
Let me out! I'll whack him and splat him! Puppy power! Man, that brings back memories. That shit was too funny. Oh, this fucking puzzle's intense. Shit. I'm gonna need some water. I don't know where I'm gonna get it from. How am I gonna get all these in one? Okay, I think I know my pattern. No, actually, no, I don't, because I fucked it up.
I fucked it up, bruh.
Oh, fuck. There's always...
There's always a way. Let your dreams be dreams. You gotta let your dreams be dreams, man.
Okay, I'm trying to control these gems. Okay. Fuck.
Oh.
Okay, I really need to concentrate for this one. Oh, I can't go up or down. It's a stalemate.
Can you give me a hell yeah?
I can give you a fuck no if you like.
But I want a hell yeah.
I can't. Man, there's no way. There's no fucking way. I can. Unless. Huh.
There's always a way.
Finally, I got more than one place. There is always a way. You're right, Stan. And I finally made it. I finally went that way. And what do you know, Bomb? 2 minutes to spare. To detonating the last bomb. With the bombs that say, the detonators that say, detonating soon to a dungeon near you. It sounds like Engine in a way. I'm not sure if it's the same voice actor, but I could be wrong. I'm just saying, that's what it sounds like. But then again, I have my headphones on at the same time, so like, I can only hear it faintly from my TV in the background. Oh, well, this has still been an intense live stream, up to level 12 of Master Kingpin, and I got to upgrade a skill set.
Hey, Dante, are you there?
Okay, just one more cake challenge.
New backpack.
New backpack.
The kiss begins with K.
Now gotta go to this guy again.
Stealth Elf found more cake ingredients beneath Shelmont shores. Man, she sure is good. This dungeon was loaded with cake ingredients we could use until there was an accident. See what you can salvage. Some bank robbers have just robbed the bank. Who saw that coming? They apparently have some cake supplies too, which is even less predictable. But I do predict you will stop them.
Okay, I think I'll give Golden Queen a chance right now, since I played a bit as Kingpin for this live stream as well. So I'm gonna play as all four characters in the Crash Edition starter pack. Golden King, yeah, imagine that. What the hell? Did Skype just end altogether? Oh, Reaper Kyle 13's asking if someone else can host a call. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna host a call, so I'm just gonna carry on playing for a bit until someone brings the call back up. Okay, so where am I gonna go now? I mean, I've just been in a dungeon, and I also recently just been in here as well. Mausoleum of Madness. So these are the only two places I can go.
Trouble Town.
Creation crystals, man. It sucks how you have to collect every single... It sucks how you can't just use one creation crystal to collect any... to create any type of Skylander. Like, you have to create, like, what you call it. You have to collect a creation crystal for all types of Skylander's elements in order to create a Skylander in a specific element. That does kind of suck in a way. Okay, I did not ask for that mode. That can fuck right off. Okay, now I just gotta stop the robbers. Nothing stops crime like royalty. Might as well do it with a queen. Okay, this is strange. push these to the side.
Light, Skylander, a stronger here.
Right, yes, they are stronger.
We locked one of the keys in this very safe.
And I apologize for, you know, the call dropping, but that's because Reaper Carl decided to, you know, we decided that someone else needed Toaster Call because I think he had somewhere to go or something. I don't know. He didn't really give an explanation to that, but that's just what I'm assuming. He probably has something to do right now. Only thing is, I can't host a call because I'm live streaming myself, and if I host a call, like, it could potentially affect the live stream. So there's no way. Like, there's no way I can host a call at this point. It's awesome how Golden Queen can turn all these enemies into gold. And like, you know, like turn them into like solid gold. And then you can easily kill them. That's actually an awesome attack, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, I got a key, now I need a bomb as well. Because I need to blow up that safe outside. Oh, two keys. Interesting. Oh yeah, of course there are two locks, so clearly I need both keys. Kill these puffs first, see what's inside this house. It's awesome that I've leveled up Golden Queen to level 5, but like, yeah. Oh, don't tell me, another one of them puzzles. But I'll see what I can do. I mean, it's not like 100%, but yeah. Wow, well this seems like one of the piss easiest ones that I've done way before, like near the beginning of the first livestream. Okay, I just sent a nudge to the Skype group, so then they can actually, you know, then it gives them more of a chance of, like, bringing the call back. I mean, I'm gonna call it a live stream after this anyway, but yeah, if this carries on, like, there's no point, really. And I'm gonna get that pickaxe over there. Well, technically it's a hammer, not a pickaxe, but you know. grab this hammer and I gotta smash that first, because then I gotta free this gem. Well, that just makes it piss easy. I knew this is gonna be a piss easy one. Okay, I don't know if it's worth like risking the connection of the live stream just to call them, but I don't know, I'm just considering it. I'm just considering whether I should actually call the group or not. Because, you know, I don't want to risk the stream crashing or anything. Someone has posted something. Hang on, I'll check after I've just beaten all these perks. Oh, some Tyrese is hosting it. Nice.
Hello.
Sup. Okay, yeah, the live stream is still going.
Who the fuck is calling me?
Oh hey Jorge, I'm still doing the live stream. I'm actually live right now. Yeah. It's just that you weren't in a call earlier, but Victor and Deontay and all that were here as well. Well, Victor also had to go somewhere and do some stuff, but
hello.
You know. Kyle couldn't host anymore, so he had to drop the call. He had to drop the entire call because he couldn't host anymore. So yeah.
Oh, well, for me, I'm already in a call with someone else trying to play this game. I'm trying to get past this dungeon.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'll join back later.
That's fair enough. Although I might be done by then, since it's kind of like the last thing I'm doing, and I might call it a live stream after this bit.
That's fine.
Alright, so I'm already looking up.
I've been going for nearly 3 hours anyway. Yeah.
Let me see. Deontay. What is he? All of the outfits look awesome, but goddammit, I want them booty shorts though. I want the booty shorts though. Goddamn. I want to see them legs. She got them legs though. I gotta say, she got them legs.
Them legs.
She knows how to use them.
Well, it's not my fault. Fucking, she just has to be hot all the fucking time. Wonderful.
Lol.
Well, I'm fucking hungry, so I'm gonna make myself food as well. Alright, so I'm gonna go. Alright?
Yeah.
Alright, later, Jorge. Okay, people, anything interesting you got to say about, well, Crash and Skylanders at all? Or what I'm actually on at the moment?
Nah.
Okay, I'm just, I don't know, I'm just trying to at least keep the commentary up.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh, hi, Tarius.
What's up?
I can barely hear you.
Really?
Yeah.
I think my settings are low. Let's see.
This one's nice. Yeah. I'll go get rid of it.
Yeah, I gotta. One second. Is this better?
All hail the queen!
Deontay?
This one's gonna be deleted anyway later on, so.
Wait, one sec.
Doesn't matter. Boom, boom, boom. Wow, what a cunt. He's firing out his fingers as well. And it's much easier to beat this guy's Cortex, to be completely honest. Golden Queen, like I said before, she's not really as much of a stronger character as Cortex is. Look, she's already low on health.
Mm. Which that's is also wow. Because you didn't really, play as her like a lot.
It's not just that. Cortex alone, you can like not play as much and still have like, you know, as much. You can still like play better as Cortex. Because he's effectively a stronger character by default, you know. So I'm just gonna put Cortex back on. Because he just does the job better. And especially since, like, Golden Queen just died, you know, it just shows how much of a weak character she is. And she's on, like, what, level 5 right now. I've just upgraded her to level 5 and she's still, like, fucking dying so easily. Interesting, like, I start with Cortex, I end with Cortex. This has been an interesting live stream. Sons of bitches. Somebody stop those bank robbers! Oh, finally we can unlock the safe. Hell, not so much assault it per se, as you just whooped up on those robbers, but either way, I'll take it. While we're taking things, how about you take this reward? Wow, bananas is our reward. Well, that's nice to know. I even earned a trophy for it, Local Liberator. Nice. Well, I've officially collected all the cake parts now, finally. Now I'm just gonna go up to the next part of the mission and I'll see what I can do. And I'm just gonna potentially end it over there since, you know, I'll call this a night. It's also, like, and I know some people wouldn't anticipate on me only like ending this early, but it's been like roughly the amount of time which I would normally like, you know, make like a live stream episode like for this series. So yeah, it makes sense as well for it to be this long, because like all my live streams for this series have been like roughly like what, 2.5 hours and 3 hours long, like between, like somewhere along those lines. Banana legs. Wow, fucking hell. Like, quick shot weapon, banana blasters, ultimate requires level 6. Okay, now I'm just gonna walk over to this guy who got me to do all these chores in the first place. You know, asked to do all these favors and shit.
Oh yeah! We have enough ingredients for the giant fake cake for chaos! And to that, I say that I am indeed all fired up!
Yes, and now the Skylander just needs to meet up with Eruptor inside this abandoned amusement park to put it all together.
Interesting place to bake a cake, but hey, whatever works.
And while that's going down, the rest of us will make a call to our favorite bad guy and set the trap. Okay, team, break!
Hmm.
Okay, abandoned amusement park. Okay, so people, I'm just gonna call it a live stream. I'm just gonna call it a night right now. Officially, so this is the place where we actually, you know, make this fake cake for Chaos. So yeah, the abandoned amusement park will be the next level or chapter we go to whenever we start. When we start the next, like, the sixth live stream of this series. So yeah, I really hope you lot enjoyed this live stream, and it's been really fun, like, doing this live. And for those of you who are actually re-watching this on YouTube for the fun of it, or just missed it, or just, like, you know, missed it live, then feel free and be sure to smash that subscribe button, demolish that like button, like or rate, however you want to put it. And comment, leave a comment below to leave feedback on all the topics that we discussed, and also like the game itself, and also like even on the episode itself, even if you even want to mention that. But yeah, but also let me know how the stream went as well, especially like whether you found it better than the last one, or whether it's been like, you know, whether it's been like just as great. But yeah, anyways, I appreciate your feedback for that if you guys do. And also like don't forget to share it with, also feel free to share it around of other people, let you know, such as your friends and family, whoever they may be. And in order to spread the word of this wonderful live stream, in this amazing live stream series in dedication to Crash Bandicoot's epic return in Skylanders Imagineers. Like, Crash Bandicoot's epic comeback should be a moment in history. It definitely is a moment in history in my case, and in the case of a lot of Crash fans as well. So yeah, Crash Bandicoot's epic comeback really is like a golden moment in history. So yeah, anyways, that's officially this live stream over. Like, that's officially the fifth live stream over. Thanks for watching, and see you lot in the sixth upcoming live stream, whenever it may happen live. It might happen tomorrow, but yeah, see you guys in the sixth, the potentially upcoming sixth live stream, whenever it may happen. So yeah, see you guys then. Peace out. Laters, everyone.